Alright, ladies and gentlemen, it's your boy VJ Saddles. We're live here at Street Vibes, and I'm here with one of the finest artists we have in the build. I'm talking of Immunizer. We're talking on the issue of olamide and Lyta. We had olamide as a problem with Lyta, and Lyta is no more in YBNL label. What is the reason behind all this? I want to discuss some discussion with one of our rapper we have here. I'm talking of Immunizer. You're welcome, bro. How do you feel today now?
I'm doing good.
Concerning Lyta and olamide. Now olamide has unfollowed Lyta. Now you know it's olamide let's say for some years now. Olamide signed him, and for Lyta to leave the YBNL, what do you see to it?
Well, you know, like in every record label, you know, the record label is like an organization. So in every record label, they have something like a business contract. You get so. Lyta leaving YBNL may be due to few reasons that most of us doesn't know. But normally, if you want to judge the situation, it can be like Lyta feels okay, his time is up with YBNL. Yeah, but because nobody really knows the actual reason why Lyta decided.
On Olamide's page, Olamide wrote there that we should know that in the record label there will be a particular time of contract signing.
Yeah, sure.
You get so, and the time of Lyta in YBNL is not yet for Lyta to leave the place. But Olamide mentioned something that it's a free word. That I think it's the right time for Lyta to leave there. Maybe Lyta has Olamide wrote there that he viewed that Lyta has another place he's going to. That was why he left YBNL. And I'm not asking now, as an artist, you've been signed to a label. Can you just leave there just like that? What do you
mean? No, like it depends on the kind of contract that I sign with the label. Okay. For example, if I sign a 2 years or 3 years contract, it like it's only after the 2 years or 3 years contract
that I've signed. But what the that of Lyta, it's not yet time.
If it's not yet time, because I don't think it should have a reason to leave if his contract is not yet expired. Yeah.
All right. You know, in this YBNL label, we have Adekule Gold before.
Yeah, sure.
You know, Olamide has signed Adekule Gold before. No one knew this guy before.
Yeah, sure.
But as the time Olamide signed him into YBNL, we know this guy we call Adekule Gold. And Adekule Gold leaving YBNL, you know, I think, don't you think there is something behind them leaving?
No, like for example now, Olamide signed Adekule Gold initially. And they had the amount of the duration of years that he's supposed to use in YBNL. Right. And you know, when he was ready, like for example, Lee Cash, when his contract expired, you know, he could renew his contract, but until he has, you know, gained the ground, he can now, you know, move on, he can now make his own music.
That means signing an artist into a label as if you're hyping the artist.
Yeah, sure. So once their contract has expired, if they are like they are strong enough to, you know, to hold their own base. So they are free to leave.
So are you now saying that Lyta is right for leaving YBNL?
I'm not saying Lyta is right. I'm not saying he's wrong, because only Lyta knows his plan. So, but one thing I'm not really sure about is his contract has expired on this.
All right, we have so many artists in the building watching us live there. What's your advice for them if they've been signed into a record label and they have an issue with their boss living there? What's your advice for?
Well, my advice for all the artists that maybe it's currently signed or later get signed should be is that once you're signed to a record label and they're really helping you grow and create a lot of fan base and making you get stuff that you weren't able to get when you were still my advice is that you should try and, you know, not get any issue with the label boss or anybody in the label, because the duration of years you signed should be complete, like should actually be complete before you decided to leave the label.
Right. Alright, so how's watching us so far? You've heard what Immunizer have said about this issue of olamide and Lyta. I hope you enjoyed the discussion. My name is VJ Saddles and this is Immunizer. Very much happy to have you on the show today. My name still remains the same, VJ Saddles. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. My name is VJ Saddles. Street Vibes, keep on watching. We love you.
Everywhere I go now, they want to smile with the boy. Shout out to those people now where they show me love.